Welcome students, today we'll deal with the topic of complement system. Now complement system comes under the barriers, that is the first barriers or the first defense mechanism which is present in our body. Now when we have talked about the innate systems or the innate immunity, I have told you that is one point that we have a complement system which acts as a barrier. So here we'll deal with the complement system. Now what actually complement system is? It is the major effector of humoral system. What is humoral system? Humoral system is antibody mediated system. Whenever there is infection, if the body secretes antibody, then it comes under humoral system. If that antibody is responsible for killing the pathogen, it comes under humoral system. So it is a major effector of humoral system. Now this complement system was given by Jules Bordet. It was given many years ago, that is in 1890s. Now this term was coined by Paul Ehrlich. Now how this system has been developed? Or how this system has been noticed. Now what did Jules Bordet found? He found that in a ship, he has taken the anti-serum from the ship and the ship was infected with Vibrio cholerae. So the anti-serum will have the antibodies against Vibrio cholerae. This is a normal mechanism that whenever a foreign antigen enters our body in response to it secretes some antibody and tries to kill that antigen. So that is the anti-serum which is found in the ship, which was found in the ship against Vibrio cholerae. He found that that anti-serum will cause the lysis of the bacteria. But side by side he did two experiments. In one experiment, he has taken that anti-serum and heated it. And then he found that that heated anti-serum has lost the activity of its response. It means that after heating, that anti-serum has lost the property to kill the Vibrio cholerae. In the second experiment, what he did, after heating, while heating, he had added fresh anti-serum and he found that the activity has been restored. Now after all this experiment, he concluded that in complement system, there is some complement mechanism found in the anti-serum which complement if some part of the anti-serum has been damaged, because when it was heated, the property of immunity was lost. But once again the property has been adopted when we have added anti-serum. So the name comes complement system. Now what is the function of complement system? Now complement system lyses the bacteria and viruses which has been infected. There is opsonization. Because of opsonization, there is phagocytosis. Remember, when we talk about the cells of immune system, we have found some of the cells are phagocytic. So those cells also get activated. They trigger specific cell functions like inflammation, secretion of immunoregulatory molecules, immune clearance, which removes immune complexes from the circulation and deposits them in the spleen and the liver. Now spleen is the secondary lymphoid organ. On the secondary lymphoid organs are those organs where there is interaction of antigen and antibodies. So the complement system is the primary barrier which is present in our body, helps in eliminating the diseases by inhibiting or killing the pathogenic substance. Now we move to the components of complement system. Now these components are synthesized in the liver hepatocytes, blood monocytes, tissue macrophages, epithelial cells of the gastrointestinal and genitourinary tract. Now normal conditions, in normal conditions, these complement systems components are present in inactive form. And after a proteolytic cleavage, that becomes active. So initially it is inactive, later it will become active. Now there is a term, proteolytic cleavage. What does this mean? Proteolytic cleavage means the protein will get cleaved. Cleaved means it will be fragmented. So once the inactive form has to convert to an active form, that whole protein has to be fragmented. Now when this get fragmented, it get fragmented into two sized molecule. One is a smaller and other is a larger. Now in general convection, the smaller is termed as small a and the larger is termed with small b. Now this is the designation what they are given whenever there is proteolytic cleavage. The smaller fragment is always denoted by small a and the larger fragment is denoted by small b. But there is exception in case of C2, the larger fragment is denoted as C2A. If it is C1, then there will be C1 small a will be the smaller fragment and C1 small b will be the larger fragment. But the exception is C2, where C2A, which was generally used to be the smaller fragment, the exception is this is the larger fragment. Now the smaller fragments diffuse from the site and initiate localized inflammation by binding to the specific receptor. The smaller fragment, always remember that it will get diffused, while the larger fragment will bind to the target near the activation. Wherever there is the activation site, the larger fragment will get bind to it, whereas the smaller fragment will get diffused. Now this nomenclature mechanisms, whenever we say this complement system is active, we have to denote a bar sign with a line over the active molecule. Now in this example, it is C3BBB. Now C is not marked with a symbol, but the active part is 3BBB. So this 3BB is active, which is symbolized by a bar over the name or the number. Now complement pathways, it is basically of three pathways: classical pathways, alternative pathway and lectin pathway. These three pathways are initiated by different mechanism which then later on will collapse to a single pathway, which will lead to the MAC complex, that is membrane attack complex. We'll deal with each of the pathways in detail. The first way start with the classical pathway. Now classical pathways has molecules C1, C2, C3, C4. All those are present in inactive form. And now when they will be cleaved, they will give rise to two fragments, C1AB, C2AB, C3A, C3B, C4A, C4B. But how they become active? Now whenever there is antigen-antibody complex, that is specifically IgM or IgG is involved, then it will help in conformational changes in the Fc portion of IgM. Means antigen interacting with IgM, it will react and it will help the IgM to do a conformational changes. And this conformational changes will expose to the binding site of C1. This is the first complement component which we are talking about, that is C1. Now C1 will now develop to an active form, which is normally present in an inactive form. Now this C1, it is a macromolecule. Macromolecules means it is a combination of different proteins. Now this is the structure of C1. Now what all are the subcomponents? It has C1Q, C1R and C1S. It has two molecules of R, two molecules of S, and one molecule of Q. And this whole structure is stabilized by calcium. So this is the entire structure of C1. Now this C1 has to be activated. Now this is the structure of C1. C1 has R2 components. Now this C1 R2 is activated in presence of C1Q. Now it is C1Q will activate C1 R2. You will see that in the next after arrow we will find that R2 has a bar over it, which means that this has become active. In the previous one it is inactive. Now it is R2 has a bar over it, so it is active. Now this activated C1 R2 will convert C1S2 to its active form. Now this C1S2 is the actual active complex of C1. So this C1 will act to the or attack C4 and it will cleave C4 into two fragments, C4A and C4B. C4A being the smaller fragment will diffuse, C4B being the larger fragment will bind to C2. Again, binding of C4B to C2 will help in degradation of C2 to two products C2A and C2B. Remember, C2A is the larger product, it is the exception. So, C2A will attach while C2B will diffuse. So, C2A will attach to C4B. So, the entire structure now will be C4B and to it attaches 2A. So, this C4B 2A is known as C3 convertase. It means that this will convert C3. Now here in the diagram, the whole complex is C1 complex where C1Q binds to the antigen body. The antibody will help in conversion of this activation of the C1 molecule. Ultimately, what I have earlier told, the same thing, C4 will attach and C4 will attach. Then it will give two fragments, C4A and C4B. And C2 will again attach, then C2 will again form C2A and C2B. C2B being the smaller molecule will diffuse away. No, so C4 and C2 will get combined to form C4B2A. That is the C3 convertase. Now after formation of C3 convertase, C3 will be cleaved. The convertase is C3 convertase. This C3 convertase will cleave C3 to form C3A, C3B. C3A will diffuse away, C3B will get attached to C3 convertase. So it will form C4B, 2A, 3B. A bar over it means it has been present in its active form. And this whole combination is known as C5 convertase. Now this C5 convertase will convert C5. So again C5 will be broken to C5A and C5B. C5A and C5B once formed, where C5A will be diffusing away and C5B will be joined. So C5B will bind to C6, then it will form bind to C7. So it will form a complex of C5, 6, 7, then their attachment of C8. So it forms C5B, 4, 6, 7, 8. Again then attaches 9. So again it forms a complex that is poly C9, and in between it is C5B, 6, 7, 8. This whole complex is known as MAC complex. It is membrane attack complex. This membrane attack complex will help in creating a pore in the membranes of the cell where there is infection. Remember, antibodies has bind to the cell wherever there is infection, and that binding of antibody either IgM or IgG has activated this innate mechanism that is complement system, ultimately generating a pore on the surface of the cell. Now the C5B, again the same, I've coming to the MAC complex. C5B will attach to C6, form C5B6. Again 7 is attaching, then there is target cells, and the target cell will help it in to insert the phospholipid bilayer. There is attachment of C8, there is formation of C5B6, 7, 8. There is structural changes and exposure of hydrophobic region and creation of a small pore of 10 angstrom. And then there attaches C9. That C9 is a polymer complex which forms the whole MAC complex. So the MAC complex is C5B6789. This is sometimes asked in the MCQs, what is the components of MAC complex? That is C5B6789. Now we come to the next pathway, that is alternative pathway. Now it has factors C3, factor B, factor D and proportin. It is a component of the innate immune system. It is initiated by most cases by cell surface components that are foreign to the host. Now activation is by breaking of C3. So C3 will get break to C3A and C3B. C3B will be bind to the foreign cells or the host. Now how to recognize which is the foreign cell and which is the host cell? Foreign cell has a low sialic acid concentration and host cells has high sialic acid concentration. Now remember that cells are the host cells and the foreign cells are the cells of the pathogen. So this complex has to recognize the cells which has a low sialic acid concentration, whereas the host cells are having a high sialic acid concentration. Now C3B binds to factor B. So the factor B will fragment it to BA, that is B is the factor and the site is small a is the fragment, the smaller fragment A and the bigger fragment B. So see factor BA, BB. So the complex here name is C3BBB. Don't get confused. Only remember the fragment initially was C3 small b. Now here when it has bind to factor B, the factor B has the fragment of BA and BB. BA been diffusing away, so what will bind? Bindation of BB. So it is C3BBB, which is C3 convertase. Now it will break down again C3 and again it will form 3B. Again 3B will attach, so C5 convertase is C3BBB3B. So if you remember, whatever has to be added, you won't get confused, because again factor B has been clipped first, then factor C3 has been clipped. Once C3 has been clipped, it will form C3B, which will attach. Because if it is forming C3A, then it will be diffusing away. Now this is C5 convertase. Again, it will cleave C5 to C5A and C5B. It will bind as the same way which I have earlier told, that it will bind to the antigenic surface and then it will pull down all C6, 7, 8, 9 and form the MAC complex. The last type of pathway is the lectin pathway. Now what does this do or how it's initiated? It is recognized by a specific carbohydrate, that is mannose. Now in human body, this carbohydrate has sialic acid. And M-lactin binds to the mannose residues on microorganisms. So MBL-associated serine proteases binds to MBL, that is MB-lectin pathways, and MB has two varieties, MASP1 and MASP2, MASP1 and MASP2, and it forms the complex, and this complex will cleave and activate C4. Once it has activated C4, it will move to the pathway of classical pathway. So it will merge with the classical pathway. So this is the overall diagram. We have a classical pathway, we have the lectin pathway, and we have the alternative pathway. All three steps will get converged and form a membrane attack complex. After forming this membrane attack complex, there will be formation of pores on the cell membrane. Membrane attack complex will form this channel ions channel so that the ions and the small molecules will diffuse across the membranes. When it is diffusing across the membrane, it will allow the liquid content, or that is the cytoplasm of the cells, to diffuse away. Whenever the cell cytoplasm has been diffusing, then it will help in degradation of the cell. Hope you have understood what the complement system is. If you like it, do share. If you have any doubt, you can do the comments. I will definitely reply you. Like it. If you really like it, then subscribe. Thank you.